There are growing concerns that once quiet communities are turning violent. This week in New South Wales, a man was shot dead after he confronted a neighbour over loud music. And less than a month ago, another man was bashed to death during an alleged fight over water restrictions.
So why have neighbourhood disputes escalated? Joining us this morning is Neighbour Day founder Andrew Heslop. Good morning to you, Andrew. Andrew, what's happened to the old-fashioned friendships going back 30, 40 years? You know, your neighbour over the fence, you'd have a cuppa, you'd have a yarn.
I think we're too busy. I think increasingly working families have had to have mum and dad at work. You drive to school, you drive the kids to sport, you have to drive to the shops now to buy a loaf of bread and some milk. You're not engaging with your neighbours anymore. And this terrible situation that's happened over the weekend, and poor Stephen Holmes, who's lost his life just for going across the road and saying, mate, can you keep the music down? I think that's just an appalling situation that we're now living in.
How sad is that? It's very sad to hear that you think we just don't have enough time to say g'day anymore. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I think that's right. I think we're so caught up in our own lives and everything that builds us together as groups that we're actually not thinking about the people who live around us. And increasingly, I think we're seeing a trend towards individualism and that stuff everyone else, you know, quite frankly. You know, what I want is more important than the people who live next door, across the street, or even in the same suburb. And I think now we've got an opportunity. You know, we've had a federal election over the weekend. We've got a raft of change and a commitment to change nationally. Mm. I think we've now got to look at how we change our communities and how we change our interaction with each other. So it's about a group rather than me.
Yeah. Mm. But look, someone who tried to change that sort of philosophy was the guy who came up with the free hugs campaign. He was even threatened with eviction, wasn't he, over trying to sort of open his home to strangers. He was hoping to show that the world wasn't such a bad place, and yet it's even backfired on him.
And his landlord has said, sorry, mate, this is not acceptable. And, like, well...
Because people were coming around to his place, right, for a hug.
Yeah.
Okay.
And how inoffensive is that? How warm and loving and embracing of the people who make up your community can that possibly be? It's smacks of a lack of tolerance and a lack of understanding, but also perhaps a lack of respect.
Mm-hmm. All right, now you're the founder of Neighbour Day, and it's held on the last Sunday of March.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so how did that come about?
Came about in 2003 in Melbourne. An elderly woman was found dead in her home, and she'd been there for 2 years. And her neighbours had watched as the letters piled up around the letterbox, the papers were there, the grass grew. They knew she lived alone, they knew she was vulnerable,
nothing.
But they did nothing. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't until Victoria Police broke in after somebody tipped them off that she was found to have died. And, of course, it created headlines all around the country as to how could we let an elderly woman pass away and be forgotten. And so what started off as a letter to the editor of The Age has now become a global event through Neighbour Day, encouraging people to knock on the door of the person next door and across the street on the last Sunday in March every year, but also to build those relationships every day of the week so that we're creating more tolerant, harmonious and embracing communities. It's such a simple message.
Sure. What's your advice on how to break the ice? If you don't know your neighbours, actually going up and knocking on someone's front door is quite a confronting thing.
It is. I moved to Sydney 8 months ago and I live in a block with 100 apartments in it. But it's that on my level, just the basic knocking on the door, g'day, I'm Andrew, I've moved into number 32. I'm just saying, hi, here I am. Here's my mobile number. If there's anything you need, anything you want, give me a call.
Really interested what the reaction was.
The reaction was, okay, yeah. And we had some international students also living on our floor who did not speak English, so that was a bit of a challenge. But when they've been a bit too loud or there's, you know, problems that we think, you know, might be affecting our amenity, it's just a really simple knock on the door and say, look, got to get up in the morning, could you turn the music down? It's like, yeah, sure, no problems. And I think we're too scared of actually taking that step, and so we stew on it. Oh, bloody Larry, you know, this music's up loud, the drums are going, you know, all that sort of racket. I want to get the kids to sleep. You know, that's what we need to get over. And we also need to think more consciously, I think, about the people who live around us and how they might feel at, you know, 2 a.m. when the stereo's blaring.
Yeah. Love thy neighbour. Words are cheap, though, huh?
Yeah, thank you.
Good to see you. We've run out of time. Thank you very much for joining us.
Okay. Thanks, Andrew.
Now, if you'd like to find out more about Neighbour Day, just head to yahoo7.com.au/morning. Follow the links and let us know, too, are you friends with your neighbours, or maybe you've got some horror stories for us, too? Love to hear your stories throughout this morning.